Hello, and welcome to A Life in Badges. I sort of collect pin badges, but not really. I've just got quite a lot of them. But each one generally tells a story about something that's happened in my life or something interesting. So I thought this would be quite a good way of talking about my life, but not in a boring, hopefully not in a boring way. Today's badge is the prosopagnosia badge from Faceblind UK, and this is a badge that Faceblind UK created in 2019. And the idea is that if you are faceblind or prosopagnostic, which is what I am, I don't recognise people's faces, you could wear this little badge, and other people who don't recognise people's faces could recognise the fact that you don't recognise their face either. So it was part of a thing from Faceblind UK. It's a really nice little thing to do. You have to have a lot of faceblind people wearing them. I mean, there are a lot. I mean, there are about sort of just over a million people with face blindness in the UK. It's about 2% of the population. It's 1 in 50. It's quite a lot of us are face blind. A lot of people don't know that they are. I became face blind after having a stroke back in 2016, I think it was. I suddenly got a very bad headache, and I noticed that my peripheral vision was kind of coming in, and I didn't really see what was happening out in the wider world. I thought, this is a bit weird. And so I thought, maybe I should just have a glass of water. So I went to the tap to get a glass of water, and I could see either side of the tap, but I couldn't actually see the tap itself. So I thought, okay, this is a bit more serious than just a bad headache. And so I phoned for an ambulance, and they came, and they said, well, it was probably just a very bad migraine or something like that. So after a little bit of discussion, they said, well, actually, maybe we should just take you to hospital, just have you checked out. So they took me to UCH, University College Hospital in central London, by Warren Street, and put me through A&E, and they left me in a corridor for about 3 hours, by which time I was feeling a lot better. Still had this banger of a headache, and I thought, well, you know, if they've left me here for 3 hours, it can't be anything that serious, so I'm just going to go home. So I came out of the hospital, and I couldn't work out which direction my home was. I mean, I know the hospital really well, I know that whole area, I've lived around there, worked around there for decades, but I couldn't work out where I lived. I later found out that actually, when you have brain damage to this part of your brain, which is where the prosopagnosia happens, which is in the fusiform gyrus, it also can affect your ability to locate where you are. It's called topographic agnosia, that one, and I've got both. So, for example, if I go to the pub and then come back from the loo and try and find the table I was sitting at, it's quite difficult for me. But in the greater scheme of things, if you have to have a stroke, coming away from it with just face blindness and topographic agnosia is absolutely fine. Anyway, so the first time that I realised that I had this was I was watching, I think it was season 4 of Game of Thrones, and I'd been watching everything up to then. I'm a great fan of Game of Thrones. And I was watching it and I thought, hang on a minute, this is a bit weird, because the actors have all got the same voices, but it's like they've changed all the actors around, and I don't recognise any of the actors at all. And I thought, well, that's a bit weird. So I went online, and I found Dr. Google, and Dr. Google told me that I probably had something called prosopagnosia, or face blindness. And I tested it out at home by looking at pictures of like Elvis and the Queen, and you know, very well-known people, that my own relatives, and didn't recognise anyone at all. Even pictures of myself, I knew that I was in the picture, but it just didn't ring any bells. Ringing any bells is actually a very good way of describing what prosopagnosia does. It's like, because when you normally see somebody's face, it reminds you, the recognition bit is that it reminds you of all the things that you know about them and all the feelings and emotions that you have. But when you have prosopagnosia, that face literally doesn't ring any bells. You can see it's a face, but you have no idea of the relationship of that face to you. And I've done a couple of talks about that. I'm for sure that on my YouTube channel there'll be something about that at some point. Anyway, so after that, I went to the doctors. I went back to the hospital Monday morning, and said, "I think I've had a stroke, and I think I've got prosopagnosia." And they went, "What's that?" Because medical professionals don't really know much about it. So that's what that was about. And so I have it. And I went to some researchers, some PhD students who were doing some research into prosopagnosia, and they took me through some tests, and then I had lots more tests about my facial recognition, more tests about my memory, more tests about my head, and I had MRI scans and all sorts of things just to make sure that the rest of my head was operating okay, which, thankfully, touch wood, It is. So that's good news. As part of this research and part of everything else that I was doing, I discovered this charity called Faceblind UK. And I joined, and I went to their AGM, and I've sort of been in contact with them. And as part of what they do, they've brought out a card, which you can show to people if you get into trouble with the police or something like that. You can, and they say, "What did he look like?" If you were mugged, and you go, "I've got no idea," because I'm face blind. And they go, "What's that?" And you can show them this little card, and it explains in sort of reasonable detail about exactly what your problem is. That it's a sort of it's a neurological thing. Anyway, so that's what. That's the story behind this little badge, the Prosopagnosia Faceblind UK I Don't Know Who You Are badge.